Life is too short for ordinary music. Jazz on WRFG, Atlanta.
Again, I'm Captain Mello, your host for Jazz on the Left Side of the Dial, your Monday night edition of Jazz to Soothe Your Soul. And in the studio, I have a wonderful couple and fantastic together as they are individual, and it's Gary Motley and Veronica Motley, and they're just sharing their story with us, and I appreciate them taking the time to come in. Gary, I wanted to talk to you about the program that you have at Emory, and I know that Emory, you're the one who developed this program over there, and you have outreach, and I'd like you to discuss that with our listening audience, and then end up talking about the annual jazz festival that you have.
Sure. With the Jazz Studies program, the outreach component of that was when I took over the program, I wanted the artists to come in and not just come in and perform and leave. We started with having the artists come in and do workshops and interact with our students because we wanted the students to have access to industry professionals to gain some insight into, you know, what is it like to be a working musician? You know, what is it like, you know, to tell their stories, you know, Dave Brubeck talking about what it was like for him to meet Louis Armstrong, you know, stories like that that are just really priceless. And at the same time, we thought that it was important that not only we make this sort of thing available to the students, but making it available to the community. And so we started opening those things up when and where possible and inviting the community to come in and be able to have exposure to that sort of thing as well, because that's the mission and should be the mission, I feel, of the university, is to provide access to knowledge like that. I don't think that it's fair for anyone or any organization to hold knowledge hostage. You know, when you really get down to it, you can't take it with you. You know, and our mission and our purpose should be about promoting that. So one of the policies that I really have kind of fought for was saying that if we bring artists in, the artists that we bring have to be willing to do that. And if they're not willing to do that, then, you know, perhaps they should, you know, they should seek other outlets for what it is that they're trying to do. But, it, you know, we want people to come in who can be sympathetic to what we're trying to do there. And we've been very fortunate in that a lot of the artists that we've brought in have been very generous in giving with their knowledge and their time. John Clayton, John Hendricks, Eddie Daniels, and the list goes on. All of these artists that came in were very selfless in sharing their time, almost to a fault. I'd have to drag them away from people and go, okay, you gotta stop now. Well, we're in the middle. Okay, I understand that, but you've been here for 4 hours. You gotta take a break. And but very, very enthusiastic and very excited. So that's something that we enjoy and has served us very well.
Absolutely. Can I ask who you're planning to have? And it's going to be in February.
It'll be in February, the second weekend in February of next year. We have a wonderful vocalist, Sacho Vasandani, who will be coming in, and I'll be doing a trio performance with him. We'll be joined by Terrion Gully on drums and a bassist out of D.C., Herman Burney, who will be coming down, and we'll be doing accompanying Satchel in a trio setting. And then, of course, on that Saturday night, we will have the Emory Big Band and also feature my the jazz faculty there at Emory. And I have, again, Justin Chisart on the drums. Chris Rickenbach is our bassist there. And Randy Hunter is our working with our saxophonist, and Dan Barasu, whom you actually heard on this recording as well. Those gentlemen are working with us over there, and of course Dwight Andrews. He and I are the professors with the program.
Amazing. Some time back, you had a very interesting workshop on jazz vespers, and you did an actual workshop on. People are asking all the time, are you going to do that again? And explain what Jazz Vespers is.
First of all, the Vespers is basically an evening music service that's usually held right at sunset, in the most traditional sense. And in this case, what we're doing is with the Jazz Vespers is it's a worship service, musical worship service that is based around jazz music or jazz music that has possible sacred themes, and it goes back to Duke Ellington and the sacred masses and the works that he created, the masses that he created in the jazz style. The history of the Jazz Vespers goes back to St. Peter's Church in New York, and I believe the first one was held about 1964. And they still continue to have the Vespers at St. Peter's till this day. And we found that this was a really wonderful way, again, of community outreach. And for musicians, you know, you're playing in the clubs and you're doing your thing. You may not be able to get to a church service at 8 o'clock in the morning if you're playing until 3 or 4 and that sort of thing. And at the same time, recognizing that you can share your gifts and your talents in a number of different ways. And I was actually introduced to this whole idea by Dwight Andrews when I first moved here, and he approached me about being a part of the Jazz Vespers, and I was like, "You want me to play jazz at church?" You know, and we had a talk about that. And he says, "Well, you know, absolutely. It's, you know, it all comes from the same source, you know, and it's just how we choose to, you know, to utilize that." And started working with him, and have been doing it ever since. So the International Association for Jazz Education, when it was in existence, decided to do a series of workshops to instruct people on how to create this, because it is such a great community outreach tool. So we did a series of presentations for them. So yeah, it's definitely a possibility that now, through some other organizations, like maybe with the Jazz Education Network, we're going to look at revisiting that.
Excellent. You've got a number of things coming. And Veronica, I know that you're also a part of the Jazz Vespers. And congratulations on the position that you hold at ROA, at Rock of Ages.
Yes.
And also the what you bring to the table, too, the vocals that you do. And that's something that and my wife says she can't take me anywhere. I end up crying all the time. I'm in tears looking for tissue because my nose is... It's beautiful. It is. It's beautiful. It's touching. It's sensitive. It's respectful, you know. And in fact, I look forward to it, you know, when you have it. In fact, you have one coming up when?
We have one coming up this Sunday, December 11th, and this is at Rock of Ages Lutheran Church in Stone Mountain. That's, the address is 5135 Memorial Drive, and that'll be on Sunday evening at 5:30. Like I said, it's a one-hour program from 5:30 till 6:30, and we'll actually be performing a lot of the music from this recording, because, as you said, there's some traditional holiday music, but there's also a couple of sacred things that we're going to be doing. So we invite people to come out to that. Also on Saturday night, the 10th, Dwight Andrews and the Atlanta Jazz Chorus will be joining them for their holiday Vesper celebration, which will be at the Rialto Theater. And actually, we're going to be premiering the composition Seasoning as a part of that group as well. And then
the CD release. Go ahead, let Veronica talk about
it. Well, I just wanted to add a bit more about the Vespers, and the thing that makes it wonderful for me, at least one other thing, is just the diversity. While you will see people, sometimes group, you know, I've heard it said that Sundays are the most segregated day of the week, and it's so beautiful to see so many different people gathered, coming together and sort of feeling safe and whole and emulating a family. And I think that's what you will experience just attending the Vespers service. You know, it just sort of, you know, I don't think people are necessarily thinking about the economy or how they're going to pay their electric bill and those kinds of things. You get to just be taken away just for a moment, and it's wonderful to be a part of.
Absolutely.
It's really cool to look out, you know, and you just see so many different faces, and And I love the idea of seeing people, and yeah, they are transported somewhere else, and, you know, for a brief moment in time, they can just, you know, put all that life stuff away and just, you know, enjoy it and celebrate being in that moment with other people that are of a like mind.
Yeah. How long have you been doing it there at Rock of Ages now?
8 years?
Eight years.
Wow.
And I think it was transformative, too, because Gary and I are both pretty private people, and we used to sort of wear our faith and our sense of spirituality very close to the vest, and keep that a bit more compartmentalized. So if you saw Gary playing jazz, you didn't necessarily know where he was from a spiritual perspective. And then that changed for each of us when we started doing Vespers. We recognized that the jazz music was absolutely an extension of what we believe and what's important. And so even on the CD, you'll hear music that's associated with jazz, but you'll also maybe hear music that, if you're of the Catholic faith, you may say, oh, I know that song. Just if you believe, you know, if you have a connection with nature, if you have, if you're experiencing a crisis of faith lost in the stars. So it sort of appeals to a very varied way of thinking and being in touch with your own sense of purpose.
Well, why don't we stop right there, and we're going to play another track from the new CD, Seasoning. And this is 89.3 WRFG, and we'll let you know where the CD release party is going to be, and you'll be able to hear this live. So he's mentioned several places where he's going to be doing this, so there's no excuse for you not to come out and hear live music. This is Captain Mello. We'll be right back. Oh, perfect timing, Ralph.
Smooth.
That was really good.
Ralph, perfect timing. Yeah. Old man.
On it. DJ Smooth.
Very good, sir.
On WRFG, Atlanta.
I mean, this is Lost in the Stars.
You know that Ralph's wife is at Inman.
Yeah.
Yeah, Dr. Cha.
Cha, uh-huh.
I know this.
Yeah, I'm walking down the
so
hall.
Cool.
Yeah, and I saw her, you know, and then the kids go, "Hi, Dr. Cha." Okay.
That's funny.
That ain't Dr. Cha, that's Cha Cha.
But those CDs I was asking about, Ultimate Broadway.
Oh, yeah.
That was 14 years ago? 96?
Yeah, it was. Okay. Yeah. That was Intersound Records when they were out in
oh my gosh,
Roswell.
Yeah.
Yeah, Toronto Stars. That okay. Did those for them, and then the company got bought out.
Mm-hmm.
And then they started repackaging, and also they started showing up as Broadway for Lovers and
yeah.
Several other things.
Okay, but like I said, one, two of them are listed on the Kindy Carlisle. I don't know how her name
did
that. She
didn't
know where
to
be found.
Yeah, really. They did some, there was, who's the pianist? And there were a couple of named people that they had gotten to do some of those things as well.
Uh-huh.
So they packaged them and started splitting the songs up and stuff, because I wound up on a record with, Peter Nero.
Okay.
And it's like, I never did a record with Peter Nero, you know. But he had done these things for the label, you know, and when the new company bought him out, then they just started scrambling
stuff
up.
One of those has been repackaged in your name as my favorite thing, isn't it?
Yeah, it sure has. Yes. Yeah, because somebody sent me an email saying that they liked the artwork on one of those albums, and they said, you know, who did you get to do that? And I said, I didn't know that album was out. What are you talking about? And then I never heard from him again.
He went, oops.
Yeah, you know.
It's not abstract. You're going Amazon.
Yeah.
And they abstract. They push.
Yeah. Yeah, so.
Well, right, so how do you make that transition in jazz from an academic to life experiences? How can you keep that? You know, they learn this music in an academic set.
Yeah.
But the crux of this music is trust this spirit.
Yeah.
And How do you make that transition?
You send them out in the street. Okay. You know, I have one kid who I had a hard time getting him to deal with it. And he, when he graduated last year, he did a cruise ship gig. And he was on the cruise ship for a year.
Ooh.
And he came back and went, you know what? You're right. Glad to tell you, you know. And that's the only way is he had to get out there, you know. And I've had students who write back years later, you know, and the stuff that we told them about, they end up living it, you know. So that's just life experience. You have to, you know, get out there and experience.
That's true. Yeah, I find that's an interesting question, Ralph, that you asked about that. Because I have, you know, interviewed some young artists, and they ain't got no experience. They ain't got much to say.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
And in the studio, we have Gary and Veronica Motley. Veronica, what was that song that we just heard and that you did?
That's a Kurt Weill. I think his last name is Weill. He's the composer, and the title of the song is Lost in the Stars. It's not usually associated with the holidays. It's actually from a play about a pastor who was experiencing a crisis of faith. And we thought we'd include that on the CD because, you know, sometimes even in our hopefulness, sometimes there's doubt and sometimes there's uncertainty, and we wanted to capture those experiences as well.
Wow, but it's very beautiful. It's very well done.
Thank you.
And Gary, we were talking about where you're going to be for two nights, and you'll be doing, I don't know if you really call it a CD release party. Is that what you call it, or just...
We can go with that. Yeah, we'll call it the CD release celebration.
Okay.
And on the 16th and 17th of this month, we will be at Churchill Grounds, right next door to the Fox Theater. Our sets will be beginning at 9:30 each night, and we will actually be, officially celebrating the release of the CD.
And you'll have boxes of CDs?
We'll have plenty, yes, absolutely.
Although they needn't wait, they are available on cdbaby.com, so there's that.
Hey, and, you know, I have to mention this because I was so rusty, but Gary asked me to do a review of the CD, and I hadn't done any writing in years, because I, like I said, in Hawaii, I lived there for 4 years, and I worked with a magazine called Sounds Good, and I did the jazz review. Then when I moved here to Atlanta, I started writing for a magazine called Strictly Jazz, and I enjoy expressing myself, you know. So when Gary asked me to do that, at first I got nervous, because I haven't done this in years, you know, because I gave that up to do the radio, which I love also, you know. But I appreciate that, because it gave me, it said to me, hey, it's still there. It's a bit rusty, but it's still there, and I appreciate the opportunity.
Oh, well, I appreciate you being willing to do that. I know we've had quite an association here for a while, and I wanted you to you know, bring your energy and your perspective, you know, to the record, and so the people could get a chance to kind of experience that from your perspective. So again, I really appreciate you doing it.
And I hope it works that way for you. you know, you guys have been so wonderful, and it is a pleasure to know you both. And I look forward to whatever WRFG can do. Our jazz department is always open to you, whatever we can do to support you and everything that you do out there. And we appreciate especially what you do in the schools and with the youth here, as well as the adults, you know, and giving them the opportunity to feed from your experience real. I'm very impressed about the social media part that you've introduced, because nobody else is doing that out there, you know,
yeah,
as far as I know. And I commend you on that. So, and we know that there's much more to come. And what, like I said, just keep us informed here. We have an open door policy. Once you come in and do an interview, you're always welcome.
All right. Well,
and you know that.
And I just want to take a moment to thank both you, Captain Mello, and Brother Rice. You have been steadfast for 10 years. You have not changed, and that is rare.
That's rare.
You know, sometimes people may gravitate towards you under certain circumstances, and when you're not so sure-footed, might be more inclined to abandon. But I have to just say, from both Gary and myself, we so appreciate you, and that
Absolutely.
Is much more valuable than anything else that you could ever offer us. So thank you sincerely.
And same goes to you guys, you know. And we run into one another, even out at the restaurant. You know?
Yes.
They came into a restaurant, I fooled them. I told them, oh, hey, we have a seat for you right here.
They turn around. It's like,
and then we got kicked out. It was that.
Do we have another? We need to know how folks can get in touch with you, your website, your Facebook page, and all that stuff like that. Let them know.
Okay. If you want to find out where we're performing and keep up with what we're doing, you can go to GaryMotleyMusic.com. If you are interested in the CD, you can get the CD at CDBaby.com or iTunes or Amazon MP3, any of those. And what am I looking out? Again, we want to remind you about the Vespers that we're doing this Sunday, December 11th at Rock of Ages Lutheran Church. We do those annually there, so you can get on their mailing list, and they'll keep you informed when we're doing Vespers as well.
Absolutely. And if anybody's listening out there after Gary and Veronica leave, if you need to get some information, I have a list of stuff going on here in Atlanta that is, you know, free and open to the public, and it's not always about having to go out and buy gifts and spend money and stuff like that to have the Christmas spirit, but just to get out, hear some music, some concerts, come to the Jazz Vespers, you'll enjoy it, come out to Churchill Grounds for the CD release celebration and enjoy this live music. And Gary and Veronica, anything else you'd like to add before we close out?
Happy seasoning.
Happy seasoning.
We'll be right back.